Hello everyone, welcome to Sources. So in this video again, we'll be continuing our discussion with respect to the questions pertaining to the GI section or the general intelligence section of the paper. So what we'll be doing is basically we'll focus on the section itself. We'll try and understand the section, the pattern of the section this year round, and also we'll discuss a couple of questions. Okay. If you talk about the section this year, the pattern remained almost identical to the ones that we've seen in the previous years. That is the kind of question that has been asked, the number of questions, also the pattern of the question, they more or less remain the same. But one thing to be noted that although the pattern remained the same, the questions were more or less on the difficult side. That is, they were more calculation intensive and actually involved a deeper sense of critical thinking towards solving them. Okay, so that in turn contributed towards making the section and the paper more complex. Okay. So, having said that, what we will be doing in this video, we will be discussing these couple of questions from the paper itself, and then we will try to understand the approach involved towards solving the same, so that whenever we come across a question such as this, we are easily able to solve them. Okay. So, let's start off with discussing the question. Start off with number 18 first. K is more beautiful than Y. B is not as beautiful as Y. J is not as beautiful as B or Y. So whose beauty is the least degree? Okay, so let's start off 18. So K is more beautiful than Y. Okay, B is not as beautiful as Y. That is, Y has to be greater than B. Okay, J is not as beautiful as B. So J is not as beautiful as B or Y. Okay, so basically if we try and make sense of all of this, we have K, Y, B, J. Okay, now we are supposed to, who is the beauty in the least degree? Then that will be J. Option D will be the answer. Okay, this is the highest and this is the lowest. I hope this is clear. So having said that, let's move on to number 19 now. How many cubes are there in the diagram? So we have been given this diagram and we are asked how many cubes are actually there in the diagram. Okay, so what we can do while solving this kind of questions is that let's just simply count the number of cubes. Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8 10 and subsequently 11 and 12. Okay, basically one cube here and this 4 cubes are missing. Okay, so we have 12 cubes. So I hope both these questions are clear to you. These are fairly simple questions. So the cube question also wasn't really, you know, complicated. In general, we could have easily solved this anyways. So, having said that, in case you are having any difficulty, which I highly doubt you will, you can go through the video and there should be more than enough for you as far as clearing the concept of the question. Just go through the video a couple of times, there should be enough. Okay. Now, in case you are looking to get a detailed solution of the entire paper itself, I suggest you look us up. For that, what you can do is you can, if you go through the description of the video, wherein you will find a bunch of details like our website URL through which you can visit our website, wherein you can go and purchase any online courses for that matter, or many materials for any competitive exam preparation. So you can purchase, make your purchase over that, or you can write a mail to us on our email ID, you can connect with us on that medium as well. It is provided, and also you can actually connect with us on various numbers for call, WhatsApp and text messages. The numbers are provided as well. Feel free to connect with us with any query you have regarding your competitive exam preparation of any sort, any examination as a matter. So if you have any subject wise doubt or any doubt in any particular topic on which you need some expertise, feel free to connect with us. We'll be more than happy to help you out in all these regards. And also if you need a completely solved paper of the same, we'll be happy to provide you with that as well. So feel free to connect with us on all of those lines. Having said that, in case you like the video, make sure you like, share and subscribe to the channel so that we keep coming up with relevant content such as this further down the line as well. We'll be continuing our discussion of similar sort of questions in subsequent videos. Until then, I'm signing off. Thank you so much.